Hello, my name is Julian. I am part of the customer success training team at Wingtra. I'm excited to give you a good overview of multispectral sensors and share key information about when and how to use them. We will go over remote sensing, multispectral cameras, vegetation indexes, and explore some study cases that display examples of what can be done. You will have access to the presentation so you can click on the links provided in many of the slides. Remote sensing is the gathering of information about an object or phenomenon without making physical contact. It sits in contrast to on-site observation, where contact is an integral part of the process. Remote sensing has been in use for many years now, and the arrival of drones has given us the possibility to map with higher resolution and even fly on cloudy days. Multispectral sensors can gather more information than RGB cameras because they have filters that can capture different bands on the wavelength than the human eyes can see. Both Microsense RedEdge MX and Altum capture the same bands used in Sentinel and Lancet satellites, which have offered great results for analyzing vegetation. There are infinite combinations of bands that create different vegetation indexes. They offer valuable insights when you compare the light that plants reflect in one band to the light reflected in another band. The most common indexes are NDVI and NDRE, since they provide insightful information on the crops. On the first graph, we can see the green curve, which is the spectral reflectance of most healthy plants. The red dotted line shows that spectral reflectance of a stress plant. The NDVI index calculates the difference between the near infrared band and the red band over the sum of both. This value will always be between 0 and 1, where 0 shows no biomass and 1 shows a healthy plant. On the second graph, we can see the same curves, but with a higher change on the red edge compared to the red band. The NDRE index is similar to the NDVI, but uses the red edge band instead of the red band in order to get more information about chlorophyll. This is related to nitrogen levels and can inform a better approach on plants that are in advanced stages. NDVI usually saturates in these stages. As mentioned before, there are infinite combinations of bands you can create, but it's important to understand what you're looking for. If you're already familiar with RGB cameras and are using them for mapping, you're probably working with orthomosaics and digital surface models. With a multispectral camera, you will be able to get more information on the same flight since the camera is capturing in RGB plus more spectral bands that are not perceivable with the human eye every time it triggers. While indexes give you precise information about crops, false color band combinations can tell you which plants are dead or highly stressed. Wingtra was designed to be used with different payloads which are easily exchangeable. In addition to RGB cameras, Wingtra offers two multispectral cameras, both from Microsense. Their entry level, the RedEdge MX, that comes with 5 narrow bands, red, green, blue, RedEdge, and near infrared, which can get a resolution of 8 cm per pixel when flying at 120 meters. This can be used for several applications related to agriculture and environmental studies. The latest model is the Altum camera, with twice the definition on each band and the additional thermal band. These two features allow you to work on more applications which need higher definition or thermal information. In order to understand the process of working with multispectral imagery, we will take a short look at what's needed. These cameras are radiometrically calibrated on every flight with a daylight sensor, as well as a calibration panel, so you can fly in different light conditions and the information will remain comparable. So the first thing to be done before every flight is to calibrate the camera by taking a picture of the calibration panel. Second, you program the camera, as well as the drone, to fly over the drawn polygon. Third, the drone performs the autonomous flight. And fourth, you process the images on the photogrammetry software, where you can calculate the indexes. Doing a recap, we have gone through remote sensing, multispectral bands, reflectance, maps, and indexes. In the next few slides, we will talk about some study cases related to agriculture and how multispectral imagery can help to maximize yield, minimize input costs, detect anomalies, and use fertilizers precisely. At some point in the vine growth cycle, the plants need to get stressed in order to produce better grapes and stop growing. For this reason, water management is very important, and detecting leaks fast can be critical for the grape quality farmers get from the vines affected. In this use case, the vineyard was flown with an Altum camera, and upon looking at the thermal map, several spots were seen to be cooler. When checking the NDRE map, it was possible to determine which spots had been leaking for longer and thus needed fast repair. On the right side of the slide, you can check more interesting cases. Replanting is an important activity to maximize yield and reduce input costs in a planted area. With WingtraOne's Altum payload, you can map a large area and still get good GSD to create a multispectral map and count precisely the number of plants that have grown. With a GIS algorithm, you can detect which lines and areas need replanting to calculate the costs of plants and labor. Phytophthora is a kind of fungus that kills plants, causing economic losses in crops worldwide. It's important to determine quickly which plants have it and to act fast so the disease does not spread to the rest of the orchard. With a Red Edge MX, it was possible to detect anomalies in the plantation. While on the NDVI it was possible to detect certain anomalies in 4 spots, on the NDRE it was easy to see 3 spots with less chlorophyll and 1 spot with more chlorophyll and thus a healthier plant. Upon watching the plants closely, it was confirmed that on the 3 spots there were fungus, while on the last spot there was weeds that were growing fast. In some cases, flying several flights and gathering multispectral information over spans of time can be useful to establish and then check the results of an action plant based on a preventative drone data. In this case, for example, there was a problem with nematodes in a peach plantation. The NDRE map showed exactly which plants or rows of plants needed nitrogen, so a prescription map was created to spray the chemicals precisely. This led to savings in chemicals and less toxicity in the environment. 3 months later, another flight's data confirmed that the spraying of nitrogen helped the plants. In the next few slides, we will talk about some cases studies related to environmental research and how multispectral imagery can help in early disease detection, restoration planning and documentation, insurance claim documentation, and research data gathering. The bark beetle is one of the most well-known insects that causes trees to die. In order to determine highly infected areas and detect it before your eyes can see it, a multispectral map can give you details about which trees are highly stressed. Here you can see a color infrared map on an NDVI map showing which trees are dead or highly stressed. This helps determine the percentage of dead trees in a forest among the stressed and healthy. RGB imagery, what our eyes can see, cannot tell us which trees are stressed, only the dead ones. When a mine site is retired, the restoration starts, and it needs to be tracked and documented precisely. Erosion can lead to landslides in a place marked by barren slopes, and it is important to follow the growth of plants and forests. With multispectral imagery, this is possible as well as looking for land shifts and changes in digital surface models. Hail can cause damage to forests and crops, and in many cases, it's important to document the number of dead plants and assess the damages. With multispectral imagery, it's possible to create different indexes and have an accurate percentage of damaged plants as well as determine where a replanting needs to take place. Doing this precisely is especially important in case of insurance claims. So we have gone over multispectral imagery, maps, indexes, and some study cases. I hope you have found this helpful and interesting. If you're already a customer, check out our basic and advanced training classes. Thanks for watching.